What are you so panicked about? You're okay. Hello. You're watching Much Ado About Something today, and I'm Donna. Well, it came a really rough storm around here, thundering and lightning. It's not as bad as I thought it would be, but everything's soaking wet. It's just been a really heavy storm. I'm out here trying to feed the animals real quick, and Ollie has storm anxiety, so he's having a fit. He's just telling me all about it. Here, here's a treat. Okay, watch out. Get your treat. I've got to feed the chickens, and then I've got to collect the eggs. And then I've got to pick the garden. I didn't get to do all of that stuff before it rained today. So I'm out here kind of playing catch up. It's Monday. There are no grandkids here today. It's messy. The chicken pen is really messy. After it comes a storm like this, it's a lot of mess. I usually put down straw. But when I went to get the straw today, they didn't have any. So now the chicken pen is a mess. I'll have to check back with them tomorrow. Go feed the little chickens. So when it comes storms, the chicken eggs are always dirty. They're always messy because they're in this small run. It's enough room for them, but it's a tight squeeze and it's messy. They get in here and scratch around on their eggs. Donald and I really don't have anywhere to store any kind of hay or straw. We kind of just have to buy it as we need it. And if they're sold out in our area, then we have to wait until they get some. And that means their pen is messy. And the eggs get messy. And if you have a big enough family to go ahead and eat several dozen eggs at a time, then it's no big deal. But we're just the two, and then we have our grandchildren that we keep, so we're not ever really making more than a dozen eggs at a time. So I usually go ahead and wash these and then put a second bloom on them. You can watch my video on how to do that if you're interested in that, and it'll make these eggs last longer until you can get them used up or get them preserved. I usually freeze mine. I tried water glassing, but I'm not crazy about that. I can taste that that lime that's in there. We were scheduled to get out here in the backyard and clean today, but that's not going to happen because we had those series of storms and everything is just soaking wet. I might have to pick that from the inside. Looks like it's going to be hard to get to, but I definitely got to pick these tomatoes. Ollie's settled down now that I'm out here and the storm is over. But my brother gave Ollie to me. He bred him with his good dog, his good German Shepherd. And then the mom that they bred Ollie with whined a lot like Ollie does. So that's where he gets that from, and he just whines, and he's always done that ever since we've had him. He just whines like crazy all the time. Now, these are a little, got little busted places in them where it's rained a lot, but that'll be okay because when I get ready to preserve these tomatoes, I'll just go ahead and cut the bad parts off. That's the thing about having your own garden. It's not like a grocery store where everything's already been picked through and everything is perfect. There are some big, beautiful, perfect tomatoes out here, like this one. Look at this thing. But it does have a crack in it because, you know, we've had these raining sessions that's come all at once. And when rain comes all at once, the tomatoes, plants just absorb it so fast that it cracks the tomatoes. But that's okay because I'm going to put these up. I'm going to make some sauce and some different things with them today. So it's okay that they have some little cracks. I'll wash them really good. This one's got a little sun scald on it. It was in the full sun. It didn't like it. So it's got a little sun scald spot on it, but that's okay. We can cut that out too. Now the tomato, I mean the cucumbers, I think they are coming to the end of their production. There are some out here, but not as many as we have been getting. So I'm thinking there probably are not going to be too many cucumbers, but we have really got a lot of cucumbers off of these little vines. So they have produced well. We're really happy with how many cucumbers we've got off of these vines. So we are not complaining, no way, shape, or form. And you can see by the shape of these, see, they were growing and then they got a lot of rain and they filled out and they're a little odd shaped. That's okay too. They'll make good pickles. I don't think the storms were as bad as they thought they were going to be. They were calling for some, we had tornado warnings and some really rough storms. So I think we got out of it lighter than we thought that it was going to be. And that's a good thing because nobody needs a lot of storm damage at this time of the year. Now these are the little tomatoes that we didn't stake up. They're just growing on the ground. And that is actually how Donald grew his tomatoes when he was growing up. They grew their tomatoes out in a tobacco field, along the side of a tobacco field, and they never staked them up. They just grew them out and they were growing and they grew on the ground. Of course, we try to do a little better than that here, but we did not get out here to stake them. And we had them, so we went ahead and planted them. And we are getting a little yield, probably not as much as we would have if we had staked them. But sometimes you just do what you can do And that's what we've been doing. We've just been doing what we can do. And sometimes it's not as great as we would love for it to be, but it's just the best we can do at the time to get some things and get some harvest out of it. I've got to take this other one. I think it's rough, so I'm going to throw it to the chicken in the other chicken pen. Check the yellow squash here. I see one back in the back. It's a little muddy after this storm out here, so it's a little messy. But that's okay. We're going to get out here and pick this garden anyway. And I think I needed a bigger basket. There is no perfect life. I don't strive for perfection. I just strive to do the best that I can. That's never been perfect. But I'm doing my best to enjoy my life and enjoy my time with my family and do all these little things that matter to us, like grow a little garden and have our fresh eggs and do the things that bring us joy. Looks like the ladybugs have got the zucchini down here on this side. We don't spray anything for bugs. Sometimes we'll put down something, but we didn't this year, so some neem oil or something, you know, but we didn't do that this year, so we're battling the bugs a little here, and that's okay. I think we got the majority of the zucchini, so it's okay if we don't get any more zucchini. Make sure I've picked most of everything. I kind of want to pick some green tomatoes and fry them, but then again, they're so good when they get ripe that I'm hesitant to do that. I haven't made any green tomatoes this year. Sorry about that. Go up here and check the kids' garden. These squash look like they've been eaten on too. I didn't pick any produce last week because, you know, our cable was out and our sink was stopped up. And there, I didn't want to have a lot of this produce in the house going bad. I thought it would do just as good to leave it out here. We've got all these little small tomatoes, cherry tomatoes, and here's David's little watermelon. It's still doing good. He is really excited about his watermelon. He wants it to get good and ripe so they can eat it. I'll need to bring a bucket so I can pull off some of these cherry tomatoes. I didn't bring a bucket out here, so I'm going to go in there and get one. It was taking two hands to carry the vegetable basket and the eggs, so taking me a little bit to get all this together. I got to go in here with the rabbits, see how they fared after the storm. Well, they're looking good. Gotta make sure they have plenty of water and food. Whew, it is so humid out here after this storm. I am just wringing wet with sweat. I got the rabbits fed, got the animals fed. I was going to give you a quick tour of the overgrown front yard, the front gardens. I have not been out here. I've been handling other things, and it really shows. This still has to be cleaned up once again. There are plenty of weeds in here we need to get up. We got some things dying back. Some of them are still thriving. We've got the hanging baskets fighting those ladybugs. They're eating almost everything that I have. There's some things dying back. There's hummingbirds eating. You might can see that hummingbird. How cute it is. I've got the garbage down at the end of the road. Trash pickup is tomorrow. But I'll just show you this this view right here. The crepe myrtles are blooming. There's the ones across the street. This one we got right here. It's hanging over the driveway and it's making a mess right there where I parked my car. But that's okay. It's beautiful, so I'm not going to do anything about it. I'm just going to let it continue to bloom. The hanging baskets are doing good. They're just growing. Donald did not get to mow. We had those severe storm warnings and tornado warnings today. So he didn't even attempt to mow. The hanging baskets are doing great. They're just full. Many things are at the end of their season and other things are coming out. Now the passion flower are not as pretty when it's cloudy as they are when it is real bright and sunny, but they're still really pretty. Lots of blooms. That'll be a lot of passion fruit. Just pretty, but really overgrown. I've needed to get out here and work out here, thin things out. And of course, I can only be in one place at a time. So I've been harvesting the vegetables and I have been working in the back and then dealing with other things. So I haven't been able to get to anything up here very much. That begonia is blooming. It's been very, very hot. All the plants seem to be enjoying this rain, but you can see where some things were drying up because of the heat. I have been out here trying to water things within reason. This hanging basket's still pretty. You can see how low the crepe myrtles are hanging here over the driveway. Now they were not this low before it rained, so the rain is weighing them down some. So I know Donald's gonna have to trim this crepe myrtle back after it blooms, but he has to wait until after it blooms because you don't trim it back before it blooms, you won't get to see the blooms. But it's beautiful, it's a beautiful, beautiful tree. Bird baths are full of rainwater. I know the birds will love that. T- time to catch some seeds when these dry out. It's getting to be the end of the summer garden, and this is how it gets at the end of the summer. It just gets full and a lot that needs to be done, and then I'm spread in between out here trying to get things done and being in the vegetable garden and trying to get the vegetables done and get them harvested and put up. Here are the angel trumpets. The rain's done them good. They've decided to grow. I still am going to take propagations off of these angel trumpets and start some new ones because they're nowhere near as big as the old ones used to be, because they've just grown and grown and reached their peak, and now they're not getting as big as they normally get. So I'm going to propagate these this year if all continues to go well, and start some others. And then here in the backyard, you can see is another crepe myrtle that I started off of the one in the front yard. I grew this little crepe myrtle and planted it back here. And it looks cool and shady back here. And there's Ollie. Hey, Ollie, you're okay. It's okay. Those angel trumpets will have blooms anywhere from 6 to 18 inches long. They'll be beautiful. The knockout rose is giving it another last hurrah. It's blooming some here. And those are pretty, but I'll be cutting back those spent blooms here soon. I would sit down in my chairs, but they're wet from the rain. So I'm just going to sit right here on the porch and talk with you for a minute. Thank you for joining me today. Picking the vegetable garden, harvesting the eggs, feeding the animals, and coming out here and looking to see how the late summer flower gardens out front are doing. They're pretty overgrown. They need some attention. We've had a lot of storms, a lot of rain. Hopefully I can get to these soon and get some of these weeds and things out of here and get it ready to cut back and get it ready for the fall rest, the fall garden. There will be some things out here blooming in the fall. There'll be some pretty things still out here, but I've just got to take out some of the weeds and clean it up a little bit, thin it out, get some of the grass and weeds and things out of it. That'll be an all-day job, so I'll have to either get the kids out here, or me and Donald will have to do it on a day when we both can do it together. But the storm did not do that much damage. I'm really glad for that, because they were calling for some severe storms. Very glad that that didn't happen. Thank you for joining me in my gardens today, and let me show you around and let you see how things are doing. There's nothing perfect here. There's no perfection. I'm just doing it every day. But there's a lot of joy in planting a garden in the front, the flower gardens and the vegetable gardens in the back. We are really harvesting a lot of vegetables out of that little garden. It doesn't look like much, and it looks like the ladybugs have eaten all of the zucchini plants. So I'm going to go ahead and pull those up probably tomorrow. Throw them in the compost bin, and you know, there is time to start a second garden of zucchini and cucumbers if you know, if we need those. I'll talk to Donald and see what he thinks. I don't know, I'm not so sure we need any more. We got quite a bit. Our little garden has really produced, and you know, we've been weighing that and keeping a tally of it, and it's been amazing how much we've got out of that little thing. So I'll share that with you in another video of the total harvest that we've got. But it's a lot of work even in these small gardens that's out here. And you know, the time that it takes to work on them, I can't keep them perfect. But I'm very pleased. They bring me a lot of joy with the flowering, the produce that we do get out of the garden, all of the, just the joy of having them this year has really been great. I've really enjoyed seeing everything grow and seeing everything bloom. And of course, around this time, I start looking and planning for the fall garden, the fall cleanup and cut back. And we usually mulch again in the fall, so everything starts to look real good when we get it cut back and cleaned out. And so that'll probably happen around the end of September when we do that. But all, you know, the fall plans are starting to happen, because we know it's going to take place before we know it. This is already the first week of August is gone, and fall starts September 22nd this year. So it's, you know, you can definitely feel it right around the corner. Even though it's still very, very hot, it's just you start knowing, you know, your senses start knowing, well, it's getting time for fall, you know, where it's getting time to prepare that fall garden. But I hope to take you along with that when we do, when we prepare that fall garden. Let me show you some of the overgrowth and some of the pretty crepe myrtles and some of the things that's going on. There's plenty of hummingbirds, plenty of butterflies, been plenty of life out here in the garden. And you can see over there the leaves and stuff all over the top of that house. Those trees were really whipping around when the storm was blowing, but everything is settled down now. Well, I'm going to sign off here, and you know I'm always glad to have you. Please, if you like this kind of content, go ahead and subscribe and like this video. You know that helps me in the algorithm. I've been enjoying making the videos and sharing with you all of this, all that's going on this summer. And we'll be decorating for fall before we know it and cleaning up the fall garden. I'll look forward to sharing that with you. Thank you for joining me. And like always, until next time.